In this lecture, we are going to discuss S-400 deal of India with Russia in 19th Indo-Russia bilateral summit. This deal was initially signed in 2016, and this deal involves a whooping cost of more than $5 billion to Indian exchequers. S-400 deal is so significant that US has already pressurized India that if India goes for doing S-400 deal with Russia, US will put some kind of sanctions on India using its CAATSA Act. So, US punishes these countries like Russia, North Korea and Iran using its CAATSA Act, which is in place from 2017. And if any country, any entity in the world involves with these three countries in terms of intelligence sharing, in terms of military sharing, then USA will put some kind of sanctions on those particular entities or those particular countries involving in kind of significant transaction with these three countries like Russia, North Korea and Iran. So it can be exemplified the way China has purchased S-400 system from Russia last year. So China has purchased 6 S-400 system from Russia, and USA has put sanctions on China using CAATSA Act. Right. And this deal comes when India is already engaged with USA, as we have seen in 2+2 negotiations, where we have gone for CAATSA agreement, and also USA has raised India's stature from STA 2 to STA 1. So what is STA 2 and STA 1? We will simply understand this STA 2 to STA 1, right? So India, USA has raised India's stature from STA 2 to STA 1. STA is strategic trading authorization, right? And to be raised at STA 1, strategic trading authorization, means India will have availability. India will have availability of more advanced defense system from USA. And India has been made an exception, because to be raised to STA 1 stature, a country need to be the member of NSG, right? So India is not the member of NSG, not even NSG. You have to be the member of MTCR, Wassenaar Group and Australian Group, right? Wassenaar Group and Australian Group. So this deal comes, S-400 deal comes, when we have already engaged with a country like USA, and USA is involved in some of the major geopolitical conflict with Russia in Syria, as we know. And Russia has also employed this S-400 system in Syria to protect the naval and air force asset of Syria, right? So what S-400 air defense system is all about? What CAATSA Act is all about? Let us try to understand. So we'll try to understand S-400. So S-400 is surface-to-air missile defense system. And the counterpart of it in USA is Patriot and Thar system. So Patriot is not in place, but Thar system is still in place. So the counterpart of it in USA is Patriot and Thar system, right? Thar is Terminal High Altitude Area Defense System. So they have Patriot and Thar system. Like, range of S-400 is 400 kilometers, 400 kilometers is range, right, of this surface to air missile defense system, right, and altitude at which it can destroy any incoming missile, any incoming aircraft, any incoming unmanned air vehicles is 30 kilometers. Right? The overall range of tracking any incoming missile or any airborne threat is 600 kilometers. 600 kilometers is tracking range. Right? This S-400 system is equipped with radars. Right? It is equipped with radar, it is equipped with detection system. One of the most sophisticated detection system it has. It can detect some of the most advanced aircrafts like F-535 also. This is a US based aircraft, F-35. So it can detect F-35 also. Right? So it has radars, it has detection system, it has launchers to launch the missile to destroy the incoming cruise or ballistic missile or anything which is airborne in nature. Launcher. It has control and command system also. Right? And S-400, one of the most significant feature of S-400 surface to air missile defense system is it has three layered missile defense system. Unlike that of Thor and Patriot, they have one layered of missile defense system. Right? Three-layered missile defense system means they have different missile system. They carry different missile system with varying ranges. We get to target at varying ranges. So they have three-layered missile defense system. Right? And this S-400 missile surface to air missile defense system can destroy any airborne threat, any unmanned air vehicle, any ballistic or cruise missile, incoming ballistic or cruise missile, right? Anything which is airborne in nature, S-400 surface to air missile defense system will destroy it. So once India has 5 S-400 systems, so it will be equipped with S-400 plus Prithvi defense system, right? तो आप Prithvi defense system के बारे में पढ़ लीजिएगा. इसके साथ जो है India's military capability will be beefed up. Right? So this is something about S-400 that we come to understand. So what is CAATSA Act? Let us try to understand that. And as the Defense Secretary of USA James Mattis has said that US need to consider wavering India, as USA doesn't want to destroy the capability of its military allies, right? So the CAATSA Act is in place to punish countries like Russia, North Korea and Iran, and not to punish the allies of USA. This is something they have said. But recently we have seen that they are talking India needs to purchase F-16 and F-18 from USA. Then USA F-16 and F-18 their aircraft, right, fighter aircrafts. So India needs to purchase these aircraft from USA, then USA can consider giving waiver to India from sanctions being imposed through CAATSA Act. So F-16 या F-18 आप जो है USA से खरीदो, but India is deciding to purchase F-16 as F-16 is already the part of Pakistan Air System, Air Force. Pakistan Air Force has already F-16 system for 30 years. So India doesn't want to purchase. USA is claiming that the current F-16 aircraft that they want to transfer to India, it is of more advanced quality, but India is denying on account of F-16 being the part of Pakistan Air Force. Also, this F-16 is not compatible with India's BrahMos system. F-16 is not compatible with BrahMos system, with our BrahMos system. Right. Okay. So now let us understand CAATSA Act and the sanctions through which waiver can be given to India from sanctions being imposed on India. Right. So under CAATSA Act, there are certain sanctions like section. There are certain sections like section 231, right? And this section 231 talks about imposition of sanctions on those entities which involves any kind of significant transactions with countries like Russia, North Korea and Iran, right? तो इंडिया का जो ये ट्रांजैक्शन रशिया के साथ है 40,000 करोड़ का, यह बहुत ही सिग्निफिकेंट ट्रांजैक्शन में आता है, तो प्रेसिडेंट सैंक्शंस इस सेक्शन को यूज करते हुए लगाता है CAATSA एक्ट के यूएस में सेक्शन 231। अब सैंक्शन से ओवरकम कैसे किया जा सकता है, ठीक है, वेवर कैसे मिल सकता है इंडिया को, तो वी हैव सेक्शन 231B and section 231B. Section 231D talks about that if sanctions have been imposed on a country using CAATSA Act, then waiver can be given under this using this section by president of USA. So 231D के तहत जो है sanctions remove किया जा सकता है अगर लगाया गया है तो, एंड देयर इज अ 236B, इज इट 236B ऑफ CAATSA एक्ट, और इस सेक्शन के मुताबिक कोई भी सिग्निफिकेंट ट्रांजैक्शन आप अगर करते हो इन कंट्रीज के साथ, रशिया के साथ या नॉर्थ कोरिया के साथ या ईरान के साथ, तो अगर वो सिग्निफिकेंट भी है transaction, they are significant in nature, still waiver is to be given, तो waiver इस sanction, इस section के provision को use करते हुए दिया जा सकता है, 236B. But what USA wants India to comply, पहली बात India अपनी जो defense production है, जो conventional weapons हमारे conventional weapons की reliability है रशिया के ऊपर, उसे हमें कम करना पड़ेगा, और एज अ मेजर डिफेंस पार्टनर टू रशिया हमें अपने आप को थोड़ा रिड्यूस करना पड़ेगा अपनी एंगेजमेंट को रशिया के साथ में, राइट, सो ये यूएसए चाहता है, बट अब ये कोई सर्टेनिटी नहीं है कि यूएसए सैंक्शन लगाएगा या नहीं लगाएगा, लेकिन एक बात हम समझ सकते हैं कि इंडिया का जो मेजर स्टेक है डिफेंस परचेज में throughout the world, ये बहुत ज्यादा हाई है, 2012 से लेकर 2016 का अगर डेटा देखते हैं तो टोटल ग्लोबल सेल का 13% आर्म्स परचेज इंडिया ने किया है, राइट, इंडिया इज द बिगेस्ट परचेजर ऑफ आर्म्स फ्रॉम 2012 टू 2016, और सिप्री की एक रिपोर्ट है उस रिपोर्ट को मैं यहाँ पे हाईलाइट करता हूँ, रिपोर्ट फ्रॉम सिप्री। राइट, दिस रिपोर्ट इज फ्रॉम 2013 टू 2017 एंड इट सेज इंडिया परचेज 62% ऑफ इट टोटल आर्म्स फ्रॉम रशिया। सो इंडिया ने रशिया के साथ 2013 से 2017 के बीच में 62% आर्म्स परचेज किया। राइट, यूएस के साथ हमारी जो रिलायबिलिटी थी वो 15% की थी और इसराइल के साथ 11% थी। इसराइल के साथ 11% गिवन दीज बैकग्राउंड्स एंड दीज फैक्ट्स दैट इंडिया इज अ मेजर इंपोर्टर ऑफ आर्म्स एंड अम्युनिशंस, सो यू इवन कंट्रीज लाइक यूएसए इज कंसिडरिंग giving weapon to India, right? So this is it. Thank you so much.